Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Today we are going to talk about the Day of Judgment, and it will take us maybe 3 to 4 halaqa or 3 to 4 jum'ah to finish it, inshallah. And this topic, it's extremely important because, my dear brothers, the basics of Iman, after the greatness of Allah and believing in Allah, is to believe in the Day of Judgment. And believing in the Day of Judgment is one of the most important things that make the person refrain and fear Allah and stop doing the wrong. And that's why Rasulullah used to say, Ya ma'asha, man amana billahi wal yawm al-akhir. And some hadith Rasulullah say, Man kana yu'minu billahi wal yawm al-akhir. Whosoever used to believe in Allah and the Day of Judgment, he should not do so. It means, what makes you stop doing the wrong is what? That you believe that Allah is your creator. And there is a day where Allah will meet you and He will take account of what you do. Even if you hide from me or you hide from anyone, you can't hide from Allah. Because scholars, they said, even if you can and it's impossible to hide from the angels, your own tongue and mouth and legs and hands will speak against you. Allah says in the Quran, يوم تشهد عليهم وتشهد عليهم جلودهم بما كانوا يكسبون وقالوا لجلودهم لما شهدتم علينا قالوا أنتقنا الله الذي أنتق كل شيء. They tell to their skin, why you witness against us? We used to strive to feed you all this work that we get the money for you so you can enjoy. So they said, أنتقنا الله, Allah make us talk, what can we do? So the Day of Judgment is extremely important. And the Day of Judgment has no doubt. Allah says in the Quran, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ أَيَّانَ مُرْسَاهَا فِيمَا أَنْتَ مِنْ ذِكْرَاهَا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ مُنْتَهَاهَا. And the Day of Judgment, my dear brothers, is one of the most important things that the non-believer deny. And As ibn Wa'il, one of the great non-believers in Mecca, and he was extremely rich and honorable and very arrogant, he came to Rasulullah when he was in the Haram of Mecca with an old piece of bone, very old bone, and he crushed it in his hand and he blew it on the face of Rasulullah as a sign of arrogance and as a sign that he is lying. He says, you pretend that if I die and I will turn like this bone, Allah will raise me again. And he blew that sand of this bone on the face of Rasulullah. Rasulullah told him, Allah will raise you and he will put you in Jahannam. And Allah revealed the ayah, وَضَرَبَ لَنَا مَتَلًا. Al-As ibn Wa'il, he gave example. وَنَسِيَ خَلْقَهَا, and he forget from where he come. يعني علماء the scholar, they said in this ayah, وَضَرَبَ لَنَا مَتَلًا وَنَسِيَ خَلْقَهَا. He gave us an example. It means he brought an old bone and he says, Allah will not raise me when I turn sand like this. And he forgets his origin. So scholars, they said, the first creation is the most difficult than to raise from the sand. Yani before, you were nothing. At least when you die, there is a comb of sand that is accumulated in your grave. So there is a basic, there is some sand. But before, you were nothing. Allah says in Surah Insan, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. You were nothing. Allah accumulate you from the food that the man and woman eat. And from this water, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates this egg in three darknesses and you become, mashallah, a human being. وَخَلَقْنَا الْمُدْغَةَ عِدَامًا وَكَسَوْنَا الْعِدَامَ لَحْمًا ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَاهُ خَلْقًا آخر فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. So my dear brothers, the question of raising after the Day of Judgment is one of the most questions that the kuffar deny. And they are from the pillars and conditions of Iman. And as you know, from the condition of Iman, to believe in Allah, to believe in His angel, to believe in His books, to believe in the messenger, to believe in the Day of Judgment, and to believe in the destiny, good and bad, from Allah. So Day of Judgment is from the pillars of the Iman. foundations of Iman. And many mushrikeen, they deny the message of the Rasul because they deny the Day of Judgment. And the Day of Judgment has no doubt. Allah says in Surah Al-Qiyamah, and this surah name, Day of Judgment. Allah says in Surah Al-Qiyamah, لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه. A man think that we are not going to collect his bone and create him back as his initial form. بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه. And the banan is the finger, the toy, the finger. تسوية البنان, scholar they said, some scholar they said in tafsir, fingerprint. Because tasweet, it means even the lines that are in the finger. And Allah said in the Quran, I will not only return you as you were before, after 20 or 30,000 years, Allah knows how much, I will even bring you back in the Day of Judgment with your fingerprint. Look at the challenge of Allah, Allahu Akbar. Qudra of Allah. Your fingerprint will come back. Not only that, the skin that was cut for the Muslim when they circumcised him, it will return back to him in the Day of Judgment. يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يحشر الناس يوم القيامة حفاة عراة غرلا. The people in the Day of Judgment, they will rise حفاة, barefoot, عراة, naked. غرلا, it means without being circumcised. سبحان الله العظيم. This is the Qudra of Allah, my dear brothers, the power of Allah. How many people died? How many people in the grave now? How many people? Billions of people. And how many people will come in the Day of Judgment? All these people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, مَا خَلْقُكُمْ وَلَا بَعْتُكُمْ إِلَّا كَنَفْسٍ وَحِدًا. That all the death of these people, billions, and the rise from the grave is like one soul. It's like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give death and rise one soul. Very easy in the hands of Allah. Uzair, the Nabi Uzair, because in his time people deny also the Day of Judgment. Uzair, Nabi Allah Uzair, he was having a donkey. And he was having tafsir ulama, they said, his lunch, the lunch of Anbiya. What was the lunch of the Anbiya, the food of Anbiya? He was having figs, and grape, tin and grape. This is his lunch throughout the day. And he was going from town to town to give da'wah. So he stopped on a town that has been destroyed by Bakhtanassar. Bakhtanassar is from Babel in Iraq. He was very tyrant ruler. And they said he ruled the world and he destroyed Bani Israel. So one of the town, he destroyed all. The kids, the woman, the baby, the man, everyone dead. So Uzair, he says to himself, أَنَّا يُحْيِي هَذِهِ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. He says, how Allah will rise this after they become like that? How Allah? And the question of Anbiya is not to deny, is to know, to want to know. How Allah will do, how Allah will do it. So Allah says in the Quran, فَأَمَاتَهُ اللَّهُ مِئَةَ عَامٍ. أَمَاتَ, it means the sleep. Because when we sleep at night, we die. This is the small death. And that's why we make the dua as if we die. بِسْمِكَ اللَّهُ وَضَعَتُ جَنْبِيُ بِكَ أَرْفَعُ إِنْ أَمْسَكْتَ نَفْسِي فَحْفَظَهَا وَإِنْ أَرْسَلْتَ إِنْ أَمْسَكْتَ نَفْسِي فَرْحَمْهَا وَإِنْ أَرْسَلْتَهَا فَحْفَظَهَا. If you take the soul and you don't want to return it back. Many people, they sleep, they never wake up. So that is the small death. So Uzair died 100 years. So when he wakes up, he wakes up with the same age as he sleep, as if he sleep one night. No gray hair, no weakness, nothing. Same, fresh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him, قَالَ كَمْ لَبِتُ. How much time you have stayed? So he says, قَالَ لَبِتُ يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْدَ يَوْمٍ. Allah told him, بَلْ لَبِتَ مِئَةَ عَامٍ. You have been slept, we have been dead for over 100 years. فَانْدُرْ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِكَ وَشَرَابِكَ. Look to your food and drinks. He had a clay of water, and he had grapes and figs. So normally the food, my dear brothers, how long it stays to be spoiled? That time there was no fridge. When you have a grape and figs, fruits, not dry fruits, dry figs. Fresh fruit. It stay maximum 2-3 days or even 5 days. Then it's spoiled. 100 years, Allah ordered the figs and the grape to stay fresh as he have it on the same time. And then Allah told him, look to your donkey. His donkey becomes sand. Which one spoiled first? Which one finishes first? The fruit or the animal?
Fruits.
Allah hold the fruits fresh for 100 years in the rain and in the wind and in the summer and in the winter. All this yani phenomenon of the nature, the fruits stay fresh as if it was kept for only half an hour. And the donkey becomes sand. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show him this power. The Qudra of Allah, when Allah give his order to anything, it submits to his order. And then Allah show him his power. And then Allah told him, وَانْضُرْ إِلَىٰ حِمَارِكَ. Look to your donkey now. So he looked to the sand turned into bones, covered with flesh, and covered by the skin. And the soul blows in his nose, and he horn, he make the noise. Nahiq. Then he says, أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. I know that Allah can do everything. A man, my dear brothers, a man. He was a Muslim. He has Iman al-Qiyamah. But he was sinner and he neglected the orders of Allah. So in his deathbed, he tells to his kids, he says, sons, this is my last will to you. If I die, burn my body. And this is haram. Muslims, when they die, we wash their body and we bury them and we shroud them in the coffin. But this is his will. He says, burn my body until I become ashes. And take this sand and these ashes in a bottle. Wait till there is a strong wind that blew. Took half of these ashes and spread it on the strong wind. The other half, go deep in the ocean as far as you can and then pour it in the water. By Allah, if Allah catch me, he will give me such punishment that nobody will be punished like me. So he had what? He had the fear of Allah. He knows that Qiyamah will happen. But he had one shortcomings. He doesn't have the yaqeen that Allah will raise him back. Sahih or not? Because he think by doing this, he will escape from Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody can escape from him. Allahu Akbar. Say Allahu Akbar. So many brothers, Allah ordered the wind. Look, subhanAllah, this hadith Qudsi, ajeeb. Just ponder over it. Allah ordered the wind to bring only the scent of the ashes of this dead man. So the sand, the wind bring all the ashes in one place. And he ordered the ocean to throw the other half. So the other half come by the order of Allah, and Allah told him, قُمْ بِإِذْنِي, stand up by my will. So he stand up, looking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, blinking. And without takif, we don't give to Allah form, but he stand up before Allah. Allah told him, مَادَ فَعَكَ لِمَ فَعَلْتَ. What pushes you? What makes you do what you have just did? قَالَ يَا رَبِّ خَشْيَتُكَ. Oh Allah, I had the fear to meet you. So because of that fear, Allah grant him forgiveness. Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام, he says, رَبِّ أَرِنِي كَيْفَ تُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. Oh Allah, show me how you revive the dead after the animal, human being become dead. How you revive them? Allah give him, ask him to take four different birds. So he took different birds. In tafsir they said pigeon, rooster, whatever, four different birds. And then Allah told them, cut them in pieces with their feather, with their legs, with their head. Cut them in pieces like a ground beef and mix them all. So he mixed them in one pot. So then he told him, take every quarter, one quarter, and put it in the top of mountains. So he took one quarter to the top of a mountains and another quarter in another mountains. Four different mountains in the head, top hill of the mountains. And then he tell him, call everyone. Like for example, he called the pigeon. Only one bird. So Allah subhanahu, he stand up, he says, "O pigeon, come by the will of Allah." So Allah show him that the flashes, the amount of flashes, amount of feather, amount of blood that has been taken in the that quarter of the mount, on top of the mountains, come in one side, and he see they get together, and a bird form, and Allah blew the soul on it. Four times. Then Ibrahim said, أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Why we say all these stories? Why? Because my dear brother, to prove you, and alhamdulillah we have iman, we don't have doubt, but Allah still give example that the day of judgment is haq. Even if you are in your grave for 20,000 years, you will raise and your memory is fresh and you are aware and you will be stand up front of Allah to give the hisab. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear that this is haq. And that's why Rasulullah, when he was giving da'wah to Abu Sufyan, the leader of Quraysh, he tell him, "Ya Abu Sufyan, wallahi la tamutanna. By Allah, you are going to die." Now, who can deny that, my dear brothers? Yani a king, when you tell him you are going to die, can he get angry? He is going to die. This is true. We are going to die. Everyone here is going to die. In 100 years from now, everyone walking on the face of this earth will be under the grave. Rasulullah said, every 100 years, everybody will die. إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. So he told him, he said to Muawiyah, "Wallahi, لَتَمُوتَنَّ ثُمَّ لَتُبْعَثَنَّ." And Allah will rise you in the day of judgment. ثُمَّ لَتُحَاسَبَنَّ. And Allah will take the account of all your good deeds and bad deeds. ثُمَّ لَيُجْزَى الْمُحْسِنُ إِحْسَانًا وَالْمُسِيءُ إِسَاءَةً. And Allah will reward the man who do good deed, and he will punish the man who do bad deeds. ثُمَّ إِنَّهَا جَنَّةٌ دَائِمًا أَوْ نَارٌ أَبَدًا. And this is the last designation, either Jannah forever or Jahannam forever. So this is the first sign, my dear brothers. The day of judgment is haq. Now, my dear brothers, what is the sign of the day of judgment, the last sign? Today, and the time is short, but inshallah I will try to just start today. The ulama, they call it al-hashar. Al-hashar, hashara, it means he gather a gathering of people that come from different corners. Allah says about Sulaiman, وَحُشَرَ لِسُلَيْمَانَ جُنُودُهُ مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ فَهُمْ يُزَعُونَ. حُشِرَ, it means they come from all corners of his kingdom to the special meeting. So the hashar, it means a gathering of everyone, all human beings from Adam till the day of judgment, all the animals. Now the animals, my dear brother, the lions, the elephant, any all kind of animals, from the animals that Allah create way before Adam, all these animals will come, all the angels will come, all the jinn will come. So the hashr means a gathering where everyone will stand up before Allah. No one is missing. وَحَشَرْنَاهُمْ, Allah says in the Quran, وَحَشَرْنَاهُمْ فَلَمْ نُغَادِرْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا. Not even one is missing. This is called Al-Hashar. Now the Hashar, how it starts, my dear brothers? It starts with the nafkh fi sur, blowing the trumpet. Rasulullah, when he mentioned the trumpet, he says, the Israfil, the angel Israfil, has been created only to blow in the trumpet. Subhanallah, look what a job it is. And we know that there is only two blow, in another riwayah three. Only three blows. Yani this angel has no job but to blow in the trumpet. But still, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in one hadith, كيف أنعم, how can I enjoy the bounty of this dunya? وَصَاحِبُ الْقَرْنِ قَدْ إِلْتَقَمَ الْقَرْنِ شاخصة بصره إلى العرش ينتظر متى يؤمر فينفخ في السور. Rasul Salam said, how can I enjoy the bounty of this dunya? And the angel Israfil putting his mouth in the trumpet and his eyes is in the arsh waiting for the permission from Allah to tell him blow, he will blow. He doesn't, so scholar they said, he doesn't put his gaze down for a moment by the fear that if he put his gaze down, the order of Allah come at that moment. Shahisan, his eyes is blinking towards the arsh. He doesn't look right or left. He just look into the arsh. You understand? Like a servant, very obedient servant. You tell him, stand up front of me when the guests come. I don't want you to do anything. Just look at me. When I tell you to do things, rush and do it. So this servant, the obedient servant, what he's doing when the guests come? He just stand up and look into the master. He doesn't go or do anything. The moment that the master told him, bring water, he rush and bring water. Total submission, the angels. So Israfil is looking to the arsh. How is Israfil look like? How does angel Israfil look like? Rasulullah says, عَيْنَاهُ, his eyes, كَأَنَّهَا كَوْكَبَانِ ذُرِّيَانِ. Kawkab in Arabic means planet. Dhurri from the dhur, diamond. It means a bright planet. What does it mean, bright planet, my dear brothers? When the planets are huge and big, they look more bright. When they are small, they look very teeny, small. It means his eyes is like bright planet on the sky. These are only his eyes. So one Arabi, a man from the desert, came to Rasulullah. And he heard him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talking about the trumpet. So he says, Ya Rasulullah, mal qarn. And the Sahaba, they said, whenever the people come from the towns to the masjid, we used to become happy because they ask questions to Rasulullah. We cannot ask him. So this man from the town, he said to Rasulullah, oh, brother, Allah, what does it mean, the trumpet? He says qarn, and the qarn is like the horn of the animal. You know the horn, they used to use it as a trumpet. It's a small from the hole of the place of the mouth, big at the end. This is the form of the sword. Rasulullah said, عِدَمُ دَارَتِهِ, the circle of the end of the trumpet where Israfil blew, the diameter of that circle, bigger than the diameter of skies and earths. Imagine, my dear brothers, how huge it is. يقول رسول عظم دارته كعظم السماوات والأرض. So when he blew, when Allah gave him permission to blow, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم say that his blow will be non-stop. So when his blow, the whole system will crash. The sky will open, the stars will turn off, the mountains will fly. Mountains, can you imagine mountains? All this chain of Rocky Mountains, Himalaya Mountains, Alps Mountains in Europe, all these mountains will fly by the power of the blow. And the people will die. Yus'aqun. Rasulullah say, a day of judgment start. It means the trumpet will blow. Sign of day of judgment start, it means the trumpet will blow. Rasulullah say, a trumpet will blow, and the man will raise a muscle to his mouth. And he cannot put it in his mouth. He will die. He says the trumpet will blow and two people are sharing the clothes. You know people when they buy clothes at the market? He says they hold them. Everyone hold a piece of it to cut it. So neither they cut it nor each one took it. They die while holding the piece of cloth. And Rasulullah say the qiyamah will start and the man is carrying a container of milk that he took from his camel, going back home, and he will die before reaching home. So the day of judgment, when it comes, my dear brother, suddenly, while people are involved in the trading, in the work of home, in the food, that come suddenly. And in that blow, my dear brother, when everybody will die, when everyone will die, ulama, they said, animals will die. Angel will die. Allah says in Surah Sumur, وَنُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ فَسَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. Ulama, they said, مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ, إِسْرَافِيل, مِكَائِيل, جِبْرَائِيل, and عَزْرَائِيل. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell to the angel of that, take the soul. Who's left? They said, he will say, oh Allah, مِكَائِيل and جِبْرَائِيل, and he mentioned the name. He said, take their soul. So he will take their soul, and only the angel of death stay. And Allah will tell him, who stay alive on the earth and sky? He said, none of them, everyone die, except me. Allah told him, أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنِّي كَتَبْتُ الْعَرْشِ الْمَوْتَى عَلَى كُلُّ مَنْ هُوَ تَحْتَ عَرْشِ. Don't you know that I written death on any creation under my arsh? Take your soul. So the angel of death will go between Jannah and Jahannam, and he will take his soul. It has been reported in the hadith that he will make such a scream that if anyone left life on earth and sky, he will die by the shock of that voice. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers, he will look to the earth and he will see everybody dead. The kings, the prince, the rich. And he will say, Ana al-Malik, I am the king. Ayn al-Muluk, where are the kings? Liman al-Mulk al-Yawm, to whom the kingdom is today? Then nobody answers. Allah will repeat the question again. Liman al-Mulk al-Yawm, to whom the kingdom today? No one is answering. Three times, no one answered him. Everybody dead. Allah will answer himself. Lillahi al-Wahid al-Qahhar. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله السلام عليكم